What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today is Monday, October 30th, 2023. We're heading to a service call in Rosedale, Queens. We have an existing maintenance agreement client that has a Trane gas-fired furnace, and she's got no heat. Let's go over there, see what's going on. Hopefully I can record some content, because it's not that often that we actually work on gas-fired furnaces. Our demographic, our geographic has predominantly, you know, steam and hydronic heating, boilers, things like that. So it's rare to come across a furnace. All right, guys, if you haven't done so already, please hit that subscribe button, notification bell to get post notifications when I drop a video, and I would really appreciate it. And in case you don't know, my name is Mike Diack. I'm a licensed master plumber in certain jurisdictions of the state of New York, the entire state of South Carolina. I'm also licensed for HVAC in New York, South Carolina, Florida, master plumber in Florida. Just got to file my paperwork. So if you're in the New York, Long Island area, give my office a call, 516-348-6300. I'll be more than glad to myself, one of my team, we're like family, we'll come out and we'll help you. We'll roll out the red carpet service and get it done. All right, let's go to the video.
Good morning, ma'am.
How you doing?
How are you? Good.
I'm hanging in there.
All right.
Yeah, what are you going to do?
Yeah. Can't complain, right?
I could.
May not get you, Bar. What's going on? I got no heat?
Oh, it says the heat is on.
Let's go see. So, heat is on. Set 75, reading 70. All right, let me go downstairs, see what's doing. All right, we have no light in there. All right. Trane XR80. No heat, gas furnace. Well, the circuit breaker panel's all the way over there, and we have a... Don't clean up yet, because I want to make sure I got power here. If I got power here, then going over there is a moot point. But what I am going to notice, though, is that the switch that's on this furnace is in it's in the down position.
Oh, I don't know why.
I don't know why either.
I never touched that stuff.
So let's see what happens. The case of who turned off the switch. And we have ignition. All right. So the end of last heating season stopped working. And because it was the end of the season, you didn't call. Understood. Okay. Yeah, I hear you. I don't like the noise this thing is making, though. That's a concern for me. Yeah. All right, let's take a peek inside. God knows what that filter looks like. All right, so there's that inducer assembly. That sounded too healthy. But I do have combustion. A little interesting there. Let's pull a limit. I'll let this cool off for a hot minute. Let's see. I'm gonna have a high limit open. 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4. Four flashes is open high limit device, as you see there. So let's let this cool off. Let the blower kick off. And let's see if we have any movement in those flames.
All right, well, while I'm waiting for the blower to turn off, I pulled off our 4-inch flue pipe just to check. There's nothing there lodging there that can be causing that noise, and there is nothing. Sometimes you see birds, rodents, squirrels, things like that, but there's nothing in there. My high limit wire is still disconnected. I'm making note that it's an L160F-40 right there. See that? Making note of that. Just for reference, and when I take this off, I'm making sure that I don't touch anything like metal to possibly short out the 24 volt circuit, even though this wire, which is insulated, is the 24 volt. This is just carries it across, so just keeping an eye on that. Updated our service ticket, and we found the service switch on the side of the furnace in the off position. We turned on, system's running. We found the inducer motor assembly making abnormal noise. We investigated that, no debris or anything visible that can cause this issue. So we're gonna let that fan kick off and turn this thing back on and see if those flames move around. All right, blower finally turned off. Let's get that call for heat back on. Our blower is running because we have an active call for heat at power startup, so it's gonna do a purge cycle. Wow, look at that motor. Oh my God. Damn. That is nuts. Let's see if I can get you a closer shot. Damn. Wow. That is insane. I actually stand corrected. I still have error code 4, which is open high limit, not the power on. Sorry, power on with an active call. So let's plug in that wire. Okay, now there's our inducer. We have our heartbeat. There's our hot surface igniter right there. That means our rollouts are good. High limit is good. If there is a thermal sensor on the blower, that's also good. It's getting 110 volts. Gas valve opens, getting 24 volts. And let's watch this flame. I'm gonna watch that flame when our blower kicks on. And for now, let's just get that back into place. Like that, okay. Watch that flame. Jumping around a bit in there, but let's see. Come on, baby. Waiting for the blower to kick on. There it goes. And looks the same. Let's follow up with a draft and combustion analysis. All right, so I'm utilizing the hole that was drilled in the 4-inch flue pipe to do a combustion analysis. I got the probe basically resting halfway inside that flue pipe, and my numbers are basically stabilized. My temperature is still slowly increasing. 440 degrees of stack temperature on an 80% gas furnace is, well, she's an 80%er, right? Taking a close look at our CO2 number, which is 8.6. We have 13 parts per million or particles per million of carbon dioxide, and we have 6.9 of CO2. So what I want to look for next, now that my stack temperature is still increasing, but as long as my O2 or my CO2 and my carbon dioxide are stable, all right, we have a reference point. So we have 8.6 and 6.9. Right, we're gonna check those numbers when we do a startup here. So I'm gonna pull that wire off of our high limit switch, right? I want the heat exchanger to cool up. I don't want to accelerate wear and tear. I just want that to cool off by means of the fan blowing. Let's let that cool off. You're gonna see our numbers are gonna increase and our stack temperature is gonna decrease because we don't have ignition anymore. But that's fine, we have our reference point of O2 and CO2. Let's see what those numbers are, because that's what the blower running, that's what ignition and everything else operational. I wanna see what those numbers are before that blower kicks on. All right, there's my hot surface igniter. That means the pressure switch closed, right? Because the inducer motor kicked on, our limits are okay. We're getting 110 volts set up, hot surface igniter. Gas valve opens with 24 volts, and then we have ignition. Let's see what these numbers are now. Okay, we know we're gonna be close to 450 degrees in our stack temperature. We know that we're around 14 particles per million of carbon monoxide. This is normal when you see that system first kick on, right? Because you don't have complete combustion, so you're gonna spike with our carbon monoxide, and then that should stabilize and go back down. But we wanna see, and we're gonna clipboard this, we'll pause it right before that furnace kicks on. All right, now let's see what our O2 numbers are and CO2. So CO2, we're at 6 and climbing, and O2 is 10.1, 10, and pause that right there. Okay, now, so we have 9.9, it was still kind of dropping a little bit, and 6.17 of CO2.
All right, off camera, I use my Milwaukee M12 digital oscilloscope. It's like a digital camera on a little thingy. And I lifted up, because there's no air conditioning coil above the furnace, I lifted up the transition from the furnace. I had a piece of canvas there, so nothing out of the ordinary. I even stuck my phone in there, but again, I can't record everything. It is what it is, but heat exchanger looked okay, and the flames, they were the same, no real movement. So I made her aware of the noise with the inducer, the dirty blower motor. She's still very inclined. She just wants to replace the furnace. So I told her we're going to email her a proposal for good, better, best on first replacement. And we'll take it from there. She's been a maintenance agreement customer of ours since 2018. So she pays a monthly service, a monthly fee for us to come for a tune-up once a year. And she pays reduced rates on service and repairs, things like that. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. Monday morning, 9:30, heading over to our next service call. Thanks for watching, guys. Be well, God bless, stay safe.